Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this epic tutorial series on Duck UI. Well, what is Duck UI? It is SwiftUI in UIKit. Well, kind of. And today we are finally going to talk about lists. Most importantly, a simple list to just get started with lists. Okay, let's just jump right into the code. Okay, now make sure that you are updated to the latest version of Duck UI, and to do that, just need to go to terminal and just open up your finder here and let's see, make sure in your pod file you do have a Duck UI added. Okay, that's that. And yeah, don't limit it to any version just yet if you don't want to. So what you want to do is just type in pod update. Okay, I've already updated my pod file and currently it is 0.3.21, but make sure that you have all of that. And most importantly, you should see that in the Duck UI framework, you will have this dlist cell, dlist controller, dlist footer, F controller, rather yet, dlist footer, dlist H controller, dlist header, and dlist HF controller. And today we are going to talk about this dlist controller. And in the previous videos, we have added our templates to our Xcode project. Go ahead and take a look at them. Basically, you just need to download the resources from the site. And you need to add this Duck UI folder with these Xcode templates too. And yeah, I would just show you. Let's go to library. If you don't have that library open under the go, hit option and it will pop up. So library, developer, here we go, Xcode, templates, file templates, and just drag and drop Duck UI there. There we go. Here we have our templates. If you don't have file templates, make sure you create them and make sure that there's a space between the file and the templates word. Okay, maybe close Xcode and reopen it again so you can see all of the new templates when you create a new folder. So yeah, let's just delete this root view controller and details view controller for now because we are going to create brand new Swift files. Let's delete these both. Let's move them to trash. And yeah, now we should get this compiler error. But before we do that, let's have this root view controller created. So let's go and select new file. Just scroll all the way down till you see Duck UI. There we go. And we have quite a lot here. First one is this document serializable, and that is needed for all lists. So let's start with that. And yeah, this is just a required one. It needs to be done only once. So let's do that right now. So let's click on the next here. Leave save as the base because it will have a separate name. You don't need to bother with that. Let's just create that. As you can see, we have created the document serializable. This is just a simple protocol. Okay, now let's move on to the most interesting part. Let's create a simple list. So just scroll all the way down till you see Duck UI. And here you see some dlist cell. Let me just talk a little bit about all of these templates. So today we are going to create a dlist controller, but there still is a dlist F controller that is for footer. And there is a dlist H controller for our with a list with a header. And of course, an HF controller that has a header and a footer. All of these tiny little images make it self-explanatory. Now, what about the others? Well, we can create a dlist cell that we will talk about in just a moment. A cell model, just a simple model. List cell with a list model. So, yeah, you could do all of those for the footers and the headers too. Let's say you started off with a dlist controller and you wanted to add a header. Then you would want to add some new stuff like a dlist header plus model. Yeah, so This is very, very expandable. You will use all of these later on when you are kind of accustomed to dlist. Okay, but for now, let's use a dlist controller. So let's click on next and the controller name and the cell mother name. So let's talk about these two. The controller name is basically the view controller name. I will use this root because this will be our root view controller. Again, you don't need to add view controller. That will be appended automatically. Now the cell mother name. Think about the cells as individual, let's say, buckets that have separate data in them. So the mother is the real bucket and the data is actually the water or something that is inside the bucket. Now we need to give a name to that cell mother, and it is basically the name of what we are trying to represent on those cells. So let's just add in here our post because that is really self-explanatory. So we will have our root view controller, or let's just name this, not just root, our newsfeed, because it's pretty self-explanatory. Newsfeed and cell mother name post. Okay, so we have our newsfeed, view controller and our post. Let's click on next and let's save it. Let's create it here. I would rather create it a new folder from it. So let's select all of those and let's see, new group from selection, and I will name this newsfeed. Okay, there we go. Pretty self-explanatory. And let's have our app delegate start our newsfeed view controller. So newsfeed view controller. Okay. Now, before we do that, before we dive into these awesome files, let's just build and run and see what we get right off the bat. And yeah, just a few clicks and we have our newsfeed here. We have our cells, four cells with some data, and we can tap it. And as you can see, did tap button with tag zero in cell with item post with a UID of zero, tap me again. And that is with the bottom of tag one on the post. And if we tap a little bit further down, we will tap the actual cell, dip tap row zero. And let's see, dip tap row one, two, and three. And of course, let's tap me again on, there we go. It is tap button with tag one in cell with item post with the UID of three. So we already have a lot covered. So there's a lot of boilerplate code added to the list. Okay. And yeah, I have added these two buttons because yeah, you most probably don't want just tapping the cell. So you want to have a few buttons, let's say an options button or a more button inside this cell. You have that right now. Okay. So let's dive just a little deep into these three. And we will start off with the mother, and that is pretty simple. Let's just take a look at it. Let me just take that away. It is a simple struct. First, we have a variable called UID. That is everything. We can add in here something else, but like a post title, I don't know. It depends all on your model. But make sure that you kind of copy and paste all of these again and again so you get your post. What this post documents realizable extension does is it actually creates a document data. So now you can have a dictionary of all of your properties and you can initialize it with that. You don't have to write UID, title name, image URL, and so on. You can initialize it with this document data. And this is pretty good when you are basically using it with Firebase, because then when you fetch all of that data, that comes in a form of a dictionary. Okay. And here we have some debug description and the description with the UID. That comes in real handy when you want to print out some elements in the console. Okay, that is for cell model. Let's take a look at the newsfeed cell. And here we have our newsfeed cell delegate, and it has a function dtab button. That is, this delegate is called on the newsfeed view controller, so you may get delegate calls from every cell. And as you can see here, we have an option for adding the button stack, which we want to have. If we have more than one buttons on a cell, we want to know which button was clicked or tapped rather. And we do have our cell added there too with our post. So inside that cell, we have access to the actual model that we implemented in that cell. Okay, here we have our delegate as usual. And what this cell is very good at is adding in the items, basically the model. And it has this item variable, and that is of type post. And now that we did set this item, we can set the label, because we have a label here, to the item's UID. So we have this text with the UID, with the item's UID. So this is where you configure your views data. Basically, you are going to provide an array of items, and this item will configure the view with that data. Here we have some views, two buttons with some tags, and in the setup views, we are laying out a stack. If you don't know what the stack is, go ahead and take a look at the previous videos where I go deep into stacks. And we are observing our buttons, and we are just calling dtab button with the buttons tag and the self. The cell is, of course, our self. Yeah, this is observing the buttons tab with reactive. Yeah, I have a separate video on that too. I'm not going to go deep into this right now, but basically this is just delegating the tab to whomever is listening, and the news feed view controller is, of course, listening. And you can bind or fetch data. Of course, this is discouraged, but yeah, you could do that in this cell too. So basically that's it. We are putting up some views and adding, feeding in the data for those views, and laying out our views, and observing some tap events or something else that you want to do. Of course, tapping on the cell is observed by default by the UI collection view controller. Okay, let's move forward. Let's take a look at our newsfeed view controller. Okay, here we have some marks for dependencies, properties, navigation item, you name it. You can add some more here too. But in the view did load, we are setting up our navigation, and we are calling our view did load setup. Those are just a few functions that make our code structure more readable. In the setup navigation, we are just setting the title to our title that we have just gave to our navigation controller, and it says newsfeed. That is okay for now. View will appear, view will disappear. Yeah, most probably you will use this in your code, so I have added that there. But let's talk about this view did load setup. And as you can see here, we have our items, so we are filling in some posts here. And if you recall, we had four posts with these four UIDs. You can feed them here, so items, but most probably you will access this items variable on the newsfeed view controller somewhere else when you are going to fetch the data, let's say from a server. But for now, this is manually. You can add this just so you can test some dummy data out. Okay, we will be talking about these two just a minute. So now let's just scroll down, set up views. If there are any, let's observe some things, bind or fetch data. and we can set up our cell. So set up your cell with custom behavior here, and our custom behavior for our cell, of course, is the delegate. So we want to add our delegate here, so align ourselves to this delegate protocol. Okay, you will see that we will, in the next episodes, we will be talking about headers and footers. We are setting up our headers and footers delegate as with our cell to like this one. Okay, now let's move on to the more interesting parts. Here we have our UI collection view delegate flow layout. What this basically does is sets the sort of design of our collection view. Now, first of all, we have here our inset for section at. We only have one section, so just keep in mind with DocUI DList, you have only one section with a lot of rows. And we can have some insets. Basically, we can squeeze the UI collection view controller as we like it. Currently, it says top left, bottom right to zero, and I won't bother because it doesn't really make sense. Well, it could for your case. Keep in mind that if you want to add a separate view, let's say on top or maybe at the bottom or maybe at left or right, you will have that option, and I will guide you through that in just a few seconds. Okay, let's see, minimum line spacing for section, that is self-explanatory. If you know anything about collection view controllers, you know, do know this line spacing and inter-item spacing. Okay, interesting part, size for item. So currently we have these squares, so I have just divided the view's frame width by 3, removed these two, I believe it's inter-item spacing or one of the other, I don't know, one is for vertical, one is for horizontal, but either way, those are one. So I have removed these two because yeah, there are three cells side by side, so I need to remove three. And I have set the width and the height to the same number. Let's see. Yeah, that is okay, I won't change. You can change anything that you want here. Okay, and here we have our did select item. So this is tapping on the actual cell, and yeah, it says did tap row. Okay, and finally we have our newsfeed cell delegate that I was talking about, when you actually tap on buttons. Well, when the delegate is fired, we do get back our tag and our cell. And as you can see, we have a post on that cell, and that post is this item. Okay, the cell item. Okay, that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. We will continue exploring our newsfeed view controller in the next episode, where we will dive a little bit deeper into these top views and what we can basically do with this newsfeed view controller to even further customize it. Now, I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.